Good morrow, intertubes. I felt like lighting candles today. It felt like a special occasion, because I have a Titan XP. Last week I wasn't even sure what a Titan XP was. I had an order for an Asus Strix overclocked 1080 Ti, which I was told at the time was the best card that you could buy. And then Nvidia had to screw with my life and create this thing. I'm not even quite sure what it is yet. I think it's a video card. So Nvidia was nice enough to send me this card, and all I had to do in return was send them $1,200. It's US, I'm up in Canada, and that means that if you do the conversion, this card costs about $35,000 up here in Canada. So we'll find out soon whether this was actually a smart investment, which I can already tell you it probably isn't, or whether I am going to have the need to take my own life, because this is a lot of money for a video card. I think you can... well, you can definitely build an entire system for, after the actual conversion, about $1,800 this card was, Canadian money, which I realize holds about the value of confetti. So I lit candles to make myself feel better. Quick rundown of the specs. If you've been living in a cave and you are not familiar with the Titan X little P, I'm not even going to get into the naming scheme that everybody is bitching about online because it's already been said. This thing has 3,840 CUDA cores. The boost clock is at 1582 megahertz. The memory speed is 11.4 gigabits per second. It has 12 gig of GDDR5X, which I'm pretty sure is the name of a spaceship. Memory interface, 384-bit. Memory bandwidth is 547.7 gigabytes per second. Why that's the 0.7 is very important, apparently. Has DisplayPort 1.4, HDMI 2.0b, and will require 250 watts of power. A minimum recommendation for your power supply is 600 watts. And if you have kids, you're probably going to have to trade them in as well. So this is a quick little unboxing. What my angle is on the whole thing is I was looking at the website, the NVIDIA website, and it was saying that this card is up to 3 times faster performance than the Titan X Maxwell architecture, which is the card that I'm running in my computer currently. So bear with me, I'm new to this whole benchmarking thing. I benchmarked computers way back in the day when they were made out of sticks and mud, but I'm going to try to hook this thing up on my computer and run some benchmarks. I'll run with the Titan X Maxwell before I do, and then we'll switch to the Titan X little p Pascal. Confusing, don't worry about it. And we'll see where it stands out of the box. Just I'm not going to play with it too much because I don't want to wreck it with one hand. I really need a tripod for my phone. Here it is. And also, cats approve. Titan X is great, thanks. Yeah, okay, that's good. Don't set yourself on fire, there's candles. No cats were harmed in the making of this video. Okay, so here it is. It looks pretty much the same as Titan X Pascal, not the Titan X Pascal, but the other Titan X Pascal. In fact, the only way that you can tell that they even shipped me the right card and that they're not just trolling me is there's a sticker on the back with my serial number, so I won't get too close to it, but not that it matters. But it does say Titan XP with the little p on the back, so this is pretty much it. You get your, I don't know, I guess there's a CD in here, or no, that's just a book. Cool, they don't even send you drivers because why would you use them anyway? And then there's a box in here, which I'm assuming has, I don't know, like a free pen or something. I'm just kidding, but who cares anyway. Enough of this talk. Let's go to the computer, plug it in, and see what it does. And here's some more candles. Ah, candles. Okay, so we're just about to run our 3D Mark benchmark. You can see here we have still the Titan X Maxwell, 1000 megahertz, Core i7-4770K, 3500 megahertz, and Windows 10. Also have 32 gig of RAM, G.Skill Ripjaws, gaming memory. I'll have the detailed rundown of the exact specs of the computer. That'll be in the video. So I'm going to turn the streaming off just so I can run this test with anything running in the background, and I will check in again when it's done. All right, so the benchmark that I chose to run with 3D Mark was called TimeSpy, and it's just the demo. I don't actually have the full version of the software because I just spent all my life savings on this video card, obviously. Anyway, here's the splash screen. That's about as much as I could get out of it. I think in a previous life I must have stolen 3D Mark's girlfriend or
embarrass them in a game of pool because this program just did not want to cooperate anytime I tried to capture any footage from the benchmark. Even after my benchmarks were ran just to have something to show you, it wouldn't let me. So to hell with it. I'm just going to do it the old-fashioned way, and I'll show you the results. So the first one here, you can see, let's blow it up all for blind people like. This was with the Titan X, and kind of an embarrassing score, not very good. I mean, what do you expect? My equipment is about 2 years old, my Core i7-4770K. By the way, none of this stuff is overclocked. It's all stock speeds. If it has a speed boost or something built from the factory, more power to it. So 4,992 3D marks, I think the cool kids are calling it. And you can see here, I thought it was kind of humorous that I'm better than 51% of all results. So I'm basically smack dab in the middle, which is not really where you want to be. But on the plus side, actually, I don't even have to minimize that. We'll flip over to the Titan X little small tiny P. And you can see what it does to the score. I jump up to 8,477. And I'm now better than 93% of all results. By the way, these benchmarks are very much not scientific. I just ran them. I'm not even really sure what I'm doing. This isn't even my house. So it is what it is. I'm going to show some clips of two benchmarks that I ran with actual games. One of them is Company Heroes 2. The other one is Battlefield 1. I chose those games because they were installed, and those are games that I play. So if you were looking for other games or tons of synthetic benchmarks or any of that stuff, YouTube is going to be filled with all of that crap. So fill your boots. I am going to bring it back to... Are you kidding me? You're back again. Okay, so apparently this cat wants to host the rest of this video. I don't even know what to tell you anymore. But yeah, you want to be on TV? There you go. So anyway, back to the benchmarking. Alright guys, that's all for me for tonight. It's morning, so hope you like the benchmarks. I did what I could. Was the Titan XP 3 full times faster than the Maxwell Titan X? No, not really. It seemed to have pretty easily doubled performance. That being said, if I had supporting specs that were a little bit more modern, maybe I would have got more out of it. If I would have overclocked this thing, maybe I would have got more out of it. If I would have put it in the oven and set it for 425 degrees, I probably would set it on fire. That wouldn't help. But anyway, if you like the video, like, subscribe, do all those things that YouTube type people tell you to do. And I'm going to sum up how I feel about these two cards with the following two little clips. See you guys later. Thanks for watching.